I just love plants because they are so variable and I'm actually experiencing all the time things I didn't expect. And to be able to see things that we weren't able to see before. This is what I really find exciting. My name is Stan Szymanski. I'm a biologist and a tract fellow at the Luxembourg Institute of Science and Technology. In my research, I'm investigating how climate change and environmental change in general may affect vegetation and water resources, and what our landscapes may look like in 100 years' time. From a long time ago, I've been interested in plants. And during my PhD, I worked on hydrology, which is the science of our water resources. And I was actually doing research, which I didn't know before, about the interactions between plant and our water resources. The thing is, in most environments, vegetation actually is the main link between water resources and the atmosphere. In semi-arid environments, 90% of all the water that does not run off is transpired by vegetation. It doesn't just evaporate from the soil. So this means that it's really important to understand how much water is used by vegetation and how this is affected by climate change in order to understand the effect of climate change onto our water resources. These little holes we see there, they are called stomata, which in Latin means mouth. So these are actually little pores that the plants use in order to regulate their gas exchange, which means they take up CO2 for photosynthesis, but they also lose water at the same time. And this is actually the connection between the water cycle and vegetation, because most of the water that is transpired from a catchment actually leaves the soil through the roots, and then in the end it goes to the atmosphere through these little holes. So you must imagine there are billions of such little holes that actually regulate how much water is lost from the soil to the atmosphere. And the plants can actually open and close these holes at a very fast rate. And my research is about how plants actually use this tool in order to adapt to the environment. When we think about climate change, we usually think about global warming. But by fossil fuel burning, we actually increase the concentrations of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. And since plants take up carbon dioxide for growing, they actually react directly to this carbon dioxide, even before the climate warms. So the first effect is actually that they can close their stomates a tiny little bit and still take up the same amount of CO2, because there is more in the air. Through this, they can actually lose less water. People previously have concluded, oh, so we are saved, our water resources will be preserved for us. But as there is more water in the ground, there can be more plants in some environments. And then they could actually even lower the water table. These feedbacks actually make this balance very complicated. So we have to go out in nature, observe what leaves do, and then formulate our hypothesis of why they do it and how this happens. With this, we can actually measure how much CO2 the leaves take up and how much water they lose. We can measure precisely, we can manipulate the conditions, the microclimate in which the leaf is, and very precisely. We can even manipulate the wind speed that is inside the chamber, and we can actually see how the stomates respond to wind, to increased humidity or decreased humidity, to increased temperature. Of course, all of this at a very short time scale. And then I go back into the lab to actually try to reproduce certain features of these leaves and see if they really behave physically in the way that we think they do. It's actually really hard to somehow connect what we measure in one leaf to the environment that leaf actually experienced. In order to be able to do this, we need sensors that at a scale of a leaf are able to actually sense what a leaf senses. And this is a great opportunity here because I'm collaborating here with really great people in, for example, material science, who develop sensors that are at micrometric scale. We can make them very small. We can put many of them onto a surface exactly in the position where a leaf is. We can measure wind speed. We can measure radiation. We can measure the temperature of the surface. So all these things that we can just measure with one combination of heaters and ultra small temperature sensors. It opens up quite amazing opportunities. And with this we can somehow better understand, hopefully, where a plant puts their leaves, what properties the leaves have in different positions in that canopy. And once we understand those principles and those trade-offs, I then want to be able to put those into a model which converts this knowledge into predictions. The ultimate goal is to be able to predict how vegetation is going to respond, for example, to CO2 in the medium and in the long term, and how it will affect water resources. But also how it will respond to water resources. So for example, we abstract water for our own use, we channel rivers which increase the runoff, and all these things, they can affect vegetation. And I would like to be able to predict before we actually make a mistake, run a model and use this model at least as a warning what might happen if we make a certain impact. The Attract Fellowship is really attractive, actually, because you get the freedom to do what you are interested in, what you're passionate about. Of course, it's very competitive and you need to describe quite well what you want to do, but you're actually flexible to follow up those surprises that come up all the way along, which is really nice.